In this video, I'm going to break down the plan to save humanity from AI as talked about by Emmed Mosto in a podcast by Peter Diamandis, pardon me, and his new paper and comparing it to Bitcoin. I'm going to share some clips. So this ought to be freaking interesting, really an interesting take, and hopefully provide some solutions or point people in the right direction. So let's see if we can. I'm going to start with a clip here from him. So let's do that. Daniel Street sent this over to me and I've been digesting it. I ran an analysis on the two papers, all right? And I'm going to share that with you in a minute, but check this out.
So I think if you look at the information age, one of the biggest successes has been Bitcoin. I mean, it's what, probably close to $3 trillion now. Look up, I think.
2.4?
$2.24 trillion Bitcoin from a little bit of code. Yeah. And it transformed electricity into money, right? And the store of value. And I looked at where the world was going and I was like, there's a lot of energy out there that's going to be turned into compute. But what's that compute going to be? Bitcoin has its benefits and it has its non-benefits. But I was like, what if you had a version of Bitcoin whereby every single coin sold went towards giving AI to cure cancer or to give people free AI to teach their kids? That would be quite something. And it's something that every country needs at once, because right now, where you are in LA, I think, Peter, the amount of AI used for healthcare on average is zero. In 10 years' time, it will be loads, and that's loads of energy. What if we used all of that to secure a new type of Bitcoin, which turns out you can do it with 99% Bitcoin code,
yeah.
And then every single coin sale goes towards helping people through open intelligence? That could be the highest dollar. And you can have exactly the same as Bitcoin.
So it's not proof of work, it's proof of intelligence.
I call it proof of benefit. Because what you want to do is start with something very straightforward, universal AI. Give that to everyone so they can compete. Give it to everyone in an open form so you know what drives your healthcare, what teaches your kids, what organizes your government, what teaches your finance. The regulated industry should all be open source AI owned by everyone, powered by demand for high quality digital assets linked to intelligence. That's your goal of the next stage.
That's your goal for the next stage. So he's really on to something here. Now, he's got this paper. All right. So in the paper, we've got a couple things here. One, find it here. Okay. It's on his website, which is this website right here, Intelligent Internet. You can pull it off there. Now, here it is. Intelligent Internet paper. July 24, 2025. Now, in the paper, he's breaking down a way to use the Bitcoin code, 99.9%, as he said in the video there, of the Bitcoin code. But because of the problems that Bitcoin's had with scaling and a lot of the issues that it's, you know, experienced, because it's limited, it's this arbitrary limit. You know, he's going to have to change it and do it a different way. So I ran these two papers through Perplexity. And if you guys haven't checked out Perplexity, I highly recommend it. I think it's the best bot right now because it combines Grok, ChatGPT, and others. And it's been really intelligent so far. So anyways, I've already gone through an entire discussion with it. So I'm just going to give you the summary. All right, here's the concise summary of each part of the discussion that we've had. Comparison of the Bitcoin white paper and the Intelligent Internet paper. In summary, the Intelligent Internet paper, white paper, aims to do for open, trustworthy, universal, accessible AI what Bitcoin did for digital money. It uses cryptographic proof, decentralized consensus, and economic incentives to form a permissionless, auditable public utility. It extends the blockchain's role from handling money to governing general intelligence of infrastructure with new layers for structured governance, public benefit based upon rewards, and universal agency for all users. Why Bitcoin's protocol is insufficient for intelligent internet's needs. So the Intelligent Internet white paper talks about Bitcoin's protocol, specifically the proof of work model. It's wasteful and it's not designed to verify real world public benefit. So it can't, in this first discussion, it can't natively tie to every ledger and entry specific to auditable tasks like AI work or data curation, nor can it support instant final settlement or structured transparent governance. all of which are essential to the intelligent internet vision. So Bitcoin's white paper described a protocol that tracks coins transfers using proof of work, which is intentionally not linked to intrinsic beneficial tasks. It lacks native mechanisms to verify record public benefits, so flexible on-chain, etc. These limitations make it ill-suited as a foundation for auditable benefit-driven AI function structure. That's where we stop. Now, after that, I asked the bot if what it was referring to was BTC, and I presume that it was, but I just wanted to clarify. So then I fed, there's another website, it's called That Is BTC, Not Bitcoin. So I fed all of the data from this website into it, right? And you've got this, I think Truth probably made this, Truth Machine. But, you know, it really goes through the entire details of what BTC is and what the difference is between BTC and Bitcoin, the Bitcoin protocol. Very does a really good job on explaining the difference. So I went ahead and educated the bot on that. And I said, all right, technical analysis, original Bitcoin. Okay, Bitcoin Core versus Bitcoin Satoshi vision, embodying two opposing interpretations of the Bitcoin's Satoshi's vision. BTC emphasizes cap blocks, decentralization, and incremental changes resulting in high fees and low throughput. Bitcoin SV, you know, here and after referred to as BSV, moves block sizes, limits, restores original scripting, and scaling for high throughput and low fees, sacrificing some decentralization. It claims to preserve Satoshi's intentions, but faces limited adoption, hasn't been adopted. The debate is both technical and social. Could it, a scalable version of the original Bitcoin, fulfill the vision in the paper? Summary, a scalable version of Bitcoin with no block size limits, high TPS, low fees, Merkle-based proofs, robust scripting, could in principle satisfy most of the intelligent internet's core technical requirements for scalable, auditable on-chain data and smart contracting. However, further protocol changes would still be needed. Shift from proof of work to proof of benefit. That's what he's trying to put it to proof of benefit into a structured of on-chain governance and make for public benefit. So, well, it's a very noble idea that Emmed Mosto has, and I would encourage people to watch the whole video in this podcast, which I'll post at the end, kind of break it down. What is missing, well, not what's missing, it's just, is the, I guess the confusion is that it's been created. I mean, Kurt Walker Jr. talked about it on my show the other day, is that through the Sybil attacks, the name Bitcoin has been hijacked. The people who hijacked Bitcoin, basically in the Sybil attacks, have completely confused everybody. And now they're thinking that BTC, what this protocol BTC, which is just an altcoin, actually known as Greg Coin. I didn't know that, but I recently found out from originally in the early days, it's known as, quote, Greg Coin. That's what Mike Hearn had called it. So this Greg Coin BTC has the name Bitcoin. So everybody's confused into thinking that it doesn't work. And so I get it, you know, but they take the Bitcoin code like this guy here and then tries to apply it to something else. When now, what's happened now is everything is beginning to fall into place. You have this robust AI, this AI that is absolutely going to go, it's going crazy right now. And we have limited time to rein it in. Now, it's a noble idea to start a brand new blockchain, I guess, and you know, you call it something like whatever you're going to call it, proof of benefit. But then you have a brand new, no track record. With Bitcoin, you have a 15-year, 16-year track record, you know? So this thing's 16-year track record that's been going on. It's never failed. And you have the longest chain of digital signatures. You don't have to start over. And it's already got so much adoption. Now, I'm talking about the Bitcoin protocol, which is the scalable version to billions and billions of transactions a second at micro cents of a cost to rein in all of these AI bots and control them through the ledger by keeping them honest. Because what's to say that whatever the AI says and does, it just erases it and says, "Oh, I didn't lie about that. I didn't do that. That never happened," to protect itself and its own interest. But if we have a way to log all these transactions on the ledger, that will help keep the AIs in check, keeping them honest, and then also giving them incentive through micro transactions, because that's what the internet was designed to do anyways. The 404 error code, you know, like the microtransactions solved through each, you know, each click, each little AI button move. So when the AIs are doing millions of transactions a second, they have to have a way to be incentivized and tracked. And that's a noble idea that he's come out here with this. So I think it's definitely worth a look and listen. My hope is that we can get, you know, gentlemen like that or these other people, the information that, wait a second, the people that hijacked Bitcoin didn't want you to use it. You know, that's the point. That's the whole point. They did not want any of this to happen. So we've got all this confusion when it's not necessary. When we have the layer, I like to call it layer zero. It's just a layer zero of Bitcoin, the base layer for everything. It's all there the entire time. Just nobody knows about it. Like the bot says, there's no adoption. Nobody knows about it. All right, so let's get the word out there and show these guys, like share this video, watch the podcast at the end and share this video and leave a comment and get the word out there. Hit the freaking ones. Thank you for watching. My name is Gavin. Hopefully this helped you. Oh, by the way, on Friday, I'm going to do a show on X. Looks like I'll do a space, not a show, but a space. We'll talk about a lot of the Satoshi stuff, the Satoshi coins moving, the protocol, what's going on, the latest news events in the space. On Friday. So I'll have, I'm not going to name who I'm going to have on there right now, but I'll have some good guests. It should be a lot of good people. It should be a lot of fun. It's going to be open. All right. Friday, 9:00 a.m. I'll see you at the top.